looks real good. Does it hurt when I do that at all? Okay.
We have a 97% survival. So that means that if you come to this hospital as a trauma patient, there's a 97% chance that you're going to walk out alive.
That's amazing.
We think so too.
How is that possible with the homicide rate up so high?
Well, it's an interesting question. There's been some people believe that if you look at the numbers since the 60s, that there's been a dramatic reduction in the homicide rate across the entire country.
All right, well, why don't you come back in about a month?
A month.
Yeah, and we'll just make sure that it's healed up okay.
Homicide rates are difficult because we know that they're affected by a lot of different things. And there are some people who truly believe that the decrease in homicide rate is not so much because of anything from law enforcement, that it actually may even be due to better medical care, that we're saving lives that otherwise in the old days wouldn't have survived.
They also, the whole trauma team, the whole unit, not only just the surgeons, but the nurses, the whole staff of the trauma unit is also, they took my two boys in. They put both of them in the same room, and they wait on them like they was their kids. And I love them for that.
What we're seeing is much much more severity. The patients are, in terms of patients who are the victims of or who are injured as a result of violence.
The problem is that these incisions that you have, they tend to be very, very difficult to heal. And because your blood pressure is so low after surgery, the last thing your body's trying to do is heal this wound.
You know, no one gets shot just once anymore. They get shot three or four times. You know, no one gets shot in the belly alone. They get shot in the belly of the head. We have a lot of patients who come in as DOAs now. You know, we don't even have a chance to do anything. They come in with no vital signs. They come in essentially dead. We work on them. We try to resuscitate them. We try to revive them, but we're not able to. To me, that's the big change I've seen in my 10 years here, is that we're seeing a lot more cases that are hopeless.
My little nephew told me the other day, I was dropping him off, and he was like, hold on, like, that was a shooter right there. And what he was meaning by it is that little boy, he known the big guys get him to go shoot other guys. So they
the issue, you know, the issue that obviously has become very relevant now is this whole idea of, well, there's, why are we, the hospital, taking care of the entire South Side? Mm-hmm. Or so much of the South Side? And it's obviously very controversial. I'm sure you know about all the University of Chicago stuff and everything. And I've been involved in those discussions. And I think it's a much bigger issue than that. And the issue is that there simply aren't enough. There's a disproportionate number of hospitals in the South Side. Specifically because a lot of the small hospitals that started as religious hospitals, things like that, they're gone. I mean, we get patients from Trinity, which is a sister hospital. It's also an advocate hospital. We get patients from Holy Cross and Roseland. None of those hospitals could be trauma centers under the current the resources required to be a trauma center right now, and they don't have the financial resources. These are hospitals that are just trying to get by.
Yeah.
They're trying to serve their communities and provide care to the patients there, and other hospitals in the same communities have gone under. And I think that's what's happening, is that a lot of these hospitals just could not take on the burden.
And this will start to heal up real slowly.
Oh,
that hurts a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll stop it.